The Philippines is boosting its local dairy industry. The Board of Investments on Monday approved the 2 billion peso Laguna Integrated Dairy Farm project of the Metro Pacific Dairy Farms. The facility, which begins operations next year, will produce 6.5 million liters of raw cow's milk annually. The BOI is expecting the project to help the Philippines achieve food security and reduce its dependence on imported milk. Data from the National Dairy Authority showed the country imports almost its entire supply of dairy, with a total demand of 2.93 billion liters. State-run Land Bank of the Philippines moves to help Filipino migrant workers achieve financial security here at home. Under the Overseas Filipino Workers Reintegration Program, eligible OFWs may avail of loans for working capital or to acquire fixed assets. Amounts range from 100,000 to 2 million pesos with a fixed interest rate of 7.5% for a single proprietor borrower. Meanwhile, a group of OFW borrowers may also avail of a maximum of 5 million pesos. Now, all loans are payable in 1 year. Land Bank says it already approved some 2.68 billion pesos in loans to over 1,500 OFWs under the program. Philippine authorities work to restore normal flight operations at the Manila International Airport. Dozens of flights were delayed on Monday after a glitch hit the NAIA's air traffic management software. The Civil Aviation Authority says the problem has been resolved, but recovery operations are still underway. Now, to address the situation, airport authorities ordered the opening of NAIA runways for 24 hours. This is not the first time CAP's air traffic system malfunctioned. On New Year's Day last year, thousands of passengers at NAIA were left stranded after the country's airspace was shut for several hours. It took days before flight operations normalized. President Marcos speaking for the first time on the new Senate leadership on social media. The president affirmed his support to now Senate President Francis Escudero. He also urged the upper chamber to continue the passage of laws to help the country's development. Here's a quick look at the flash business headlines from overseas. Apple launches an aggressive discounting campaign in China, offering discounts of up to $300 on select iPhone models. Now, the campaign is even more substantial than the one Apple offered in February and comes as the tech giant seeks to defend its position in the high-end smartphone market, where it faces increasing competition from local rivals such as Huawei. Now, for another tech giant, Microsoft, it's debuted Monday a new category of personal computers with AI features. Now, this as it rushes, in fact, build the emerging technology into products across its business with compete with Google's parent Alphabet. Now, Microsoft introduced its so-called Copilot Plus PC, saying they can handle more artificial intelligence tasks without calling on cloud data centers. The new computers start at $1,000 and begin shipping next month. And finally, Trump Media and Technology Group reports a quarterly net loss of $327 million. Total revenue for the three-month period, meanwhile, was at $770,000. The parent company of Donald Trump's Truth Social platform debuted on the NASDAQ in March after a merger with a shell company, Digital World Acquisition Corporation.